How toxin can damage the thyroid and lead to weight gain. Struggling with stubborn weight gain can be maddening. And when you can't get off the weight loss plateau, you may suspect that your thyroid function isn't up to real stuff, right? But don't blame it 100% on your thyroid, because often it's toxins behind the scenes causing the real issues. Normally, when women are grappling with stubborn pounds that they just can't seem to shed, they will go to their doctors for help. Doctors typically follow a standard protocol, which is to run a blood test and then maybe prescribe a thyroid medication. While this may help somewhat with the symptoms, they never address the reason why your thyroid isn't functioning optimally. Do you know that many women are overloaded with toxins and that's why their thyroid isn't functioning optimally? And that in order to detox properly, you need a medically guided three-phase detox to clear your liver and restore your thyroid function. Type yes or no in the comment box below. And if you find this content helpful, let me know by liking this video or subscribing below. The truth is, the average woman is exposed to thousands of toxins every week from food, water and the drinks they consume. Beauty care, makeup, perfume and even cleaning products can be the culprit. The prevalence of thyroid disease has skyrocketed within the past few decades. According to the American Thyroid Association, an estimated 20 million Americans have some form of thyroid disease. This alarming trend begs the question, what is responsible for the epidemic of thyroid dysfunction? A growing body of research indicates that exposure to environmental toxins is a key piece of the thyroid disease puzzle. The thyroid is a small gland in your neck, but vitally important endocrine gland, which is present at the base of your neck. It releases a steady stream of hormones that are intrinsically involved in the regulation of metabolism, as well as endocrine, cardiovascular, neurological, and immune function. Despite the powerful role the thyroid plays in the body, it's quite susceptible to damage from exogenous influences such as environmental toxins. This is due in part to the fact that several categories of environmental toxins bear a structural similarity to thyroid hormones. In addition, the thyroid gland has a naturally high affinity for halogens and metals. While this affinity is intended to draw iodine, which is a halogen, and selenium, a metalloid, into the thyroid for the production and metabolism of your thyroid hormones, it can also lead to accumulation of harmful halogens and metals within the glands. The types of toxins that affect the thyroid are thus primarily substances that mimic thyroid hormone structure containing halogens or other heavy metals. These toxins can be divided into four main groups based on their source: industrial chemicals, pesticides and herbicides, toxins in consumer goods and other heavy metals. Perchlorate accumulates on the surface water, groundwater, soil, food grown in contaminated soil, drinking water, grains produced, dairy products from animals raised on contaminated soil may contain elevated amount of perchlorate. The thyroid gland is the primary target of the perchlorate toxicity in humans. Urinary perchlorate levels, which are representative of the body's burden of perchlorate, are associated with decreased thyroxine or T4 and increased thyroid stimulating hormone. Research also indicates that perchlorate can disrupt thyroid function at both high and low doses, overturning their commonly held belief in toxicology that the dose makes the poison. Perchlorate contains chlorine, which is a halogen with the same ionic charge such as iodine. Perchlorate thus disrupts thyroid function by competing with this iodide, an essential component of T4, for uptake by the thyroid gland. This results in reduced thyroid hormone production. Polychlorinated biphenyls or PCBs are another group of industrial toxins that have harmful effects on the thyroid. These man-made chemicals are resistant to temperature and pressure and have been used in electrical equipments as lubricants and in the production of plastics, adhesives, and paints. Despite being banned in the United States in 1979, PCBs continue to resist degradation and persist in the environment. Research indicates that PCBs disrupt thyroid function through a variety of mechanisms. They suppress the production of your thyroid hormone receptor, reducing the number of the receptors within your thyroid hormone gland or to which your thyroid hormone can bind in the body. Dioxin is a byproduct of manufacturing processes, including pesticides and plastic production. Dioxin exposure at levels considered standard in the United States has been associated with decreased T4 and reduced thyroid function, with females more significantly affected than males. Pesticides and herbicides disrupt thyroid function by interfering with the thyroid hormone gene expression and inhibiting the thyroid uptake of iodine, binding to the thyroid hormone transport proteins and reducing cellular uptake of the thyroid hormone and increasing thyroid hormone clearance from the body. The heavy metals with the most significant impact on thyroid function are cadmium, lead, mercury, and aluminium. Most patients also have nutritional deficiencies and are unable to remove these toxins effectively. They need to have optimal levels of iodine and selenium. Optimal iodine and selenium intake has been found to dampen the toxic effects that heavy metals and perchlorate can have on your thyroid. A guided cellular detox compared to a juice cleanses and colon cleanses that don't get rid of your industrial chemicals from your liver is actually necessary. And until you clean up your environment, you need to help your body to get rid of these toxins effectively. Even when you are doing all these cleanses, which are available over the counter, they are not supporting your liver and gut at the cellular level. You need to support the liver and gut at the cellular levels with adequate amount of proteins, vitamins, minerals, so that they can bind to these toxins and get rid of it in the phase 2 detoxification. Because there are different phases. There are phase 1, which converts an insoluble toxin into an intermediate product. And then phase 2 converts this intermediate product into a soluble product. And phase 3 is getting rid of it through your stool and kidneys, through urine and stool, right? So you need all these nutrients, key nutrients are necessary for your liver and gut to act effectively. Until you do that, until you clean up these toxins and help your body, all the thyroid pills in the world won't return your energy to 100%, and it won't help you with weight loss either. Because one, you have overload of toxins which cause inflammation. Inflammation will stimulate your cortisol, your insulin, which are fat storing hormones, and will defeat whatever you are doing, like eating right and exercising to try to lose weight. Thank you for watching this video. And if you are interested in partnering with me or just learning more about keeping your hormones in check, click the link below to sign up for my complimentary strategy session.